Welcome to this year's International Cake Exploration Society virtual egg convention. It has never been like this, I'm telling you the truth. But I'm glad to be part of it. It's the first of its kind, and I'm glad. And my name is Chineze Ibuoka. I'm the CEO of Honeysuckle Cakes. I am talking to you all the way from Lagos, Nigeria. Hooray! My social media handles are Honeysuckle Cakes, at Honeysuckle Cakes. For Instagram, for Facebook, at Honeysuckle Cakes. I want to acknowledge International Cake Exploration Society for the opportunity they've given to me to be part of this year's convention. I mean, it's not a common thing, it's not the usual thing we're used to, but I'm privileged to be here and I'm glad. I hope you're glad looking at me wherever you're watching from. I'm glad to be here. It's a privilege to be here, and then to be in this virtual convention, like I said earlier. I'll be taking us on a very exciting topic. I love flowers. In fact, all my life I've always, once it comes to cake, once it comes to flowers, you have gotten me. In fact, recently I wrote a book, Exotic Sugar Flowers, you know, on flowers. I love it. So I'm going to be taking you on this beautiful flower. It's Moth Orchid. It's also known as Phalaenopsis. And it's a simple flower to do. It's just that it's delicate and it's super fine. Most of the time I love to do it. So today I'm going to be telling you how to do it, how to cut, how to wire, and then how to probably give you a little bit of an idea on how to dust. And then put it together to produce this. You can put it, I tried to put it on a cake, and I tried to put it on a breast. So you can actually put it anywhere you want. I hope you are excited as I am. Please come on, let's have a wonderful time. I love you guys, sit tight. Okay, I'm already introduced the flower, our beautiful moth orchid. So I'm going to just try to run you through some of the cutters that we're going to be using today, some of the materials. I know you have them at home, so you can always make use of them. You have the normal, your modeling tool set available, the ball tools. We have the pad, my floral pad, some dust colors, sugarcraft knife, my tape, floral tape. Then the cutters for moth orchid, the veiners, okay, and then some of my flower dryers, brushes, wires, which is one of the most important. I prefer to use white wires because they don't see through them when you're looking at the petal. The floral pad, some corn flour, and then some other things here and there. My running pin, tweezers. So they're just regular things, nothing too new and all that. And I know you'll be able to use it. Okay, so I work with flour paste. Some of us call it dog paste. My flour paste is made of CMC. I make mine with CMC. I know some use some tragacans and all that, but I do mine with CMC. So I just soften it a little so that it responds to you, and then freshen it. This is corn flour. I'll be making use of it. So just a little here, a little there. Okay, so right now, the group board that we have, like I said, sometimes people find it hard to do it, but I think it's a very easy one to use. I'm going to make a sausage, start with making a sausage. A sausage, because I want to use, I have the advantage of cutting the fine groups, so I do a sausage and then roll it out. It's very important to roll this and make it thick. If you want to get the groove out, make it thick, then you can now, when you're spreading it on the groove, you can get the thin lines that you, I mean the fine texture that you want. So for this to work, there are so many ways I can use sharpening, vegetable sharpening. It works for me, corn flour. But sometimes I just use a vegetable spray and it helps me a lot. Just spray it little, just don't make it to come out so much. So you place the sausage spread out, a gum paste that you have made, and then you just roll. Camera, please let the eyes be here. Just direct them here. Please, if you have any question, remember to DM me at Honeysuckle Cakes, Instagram, Facebook, Honeysuckle Cakes. I will answer your question because this is pre-recorded. I may not respond immediately, but I'll answer after the class. So this is what I do to get the groove out. I just move forward. Forward ever, okay? Backward never. We thank God for life. Okay, so when I do that, you see how I just cleaned out the back of it, and then I'll bring out my paste. You can see it's as thin as can be. So as soon as I get it to this stage, what I'll do now is to cut. Okay, the moth orchid has this wingy part that is two, one on this side and one on this side. Then it has the head one, and then the wings down here. So we're going to do those five. In fact, let me put it in more graphic way so that you understand where we're going. This is for the two wingy ones. This is the head one. In fact, in my Honeysuckle Exotic Sugar book that I wrote, just launched it last year. Most of the time, this is the book, most of the time I put out the petals before I do the description so that you have an idea where you're going. When you get there, you will know. So can you see, even without mine, I have something that looks like an orchid. So with this out now, I'm going to cut one petal of each. I already have the petals cut out. Because of time, I have the petals cut out already. So what I'll do is to cut out one of each of these quarters, and then I'll wire them. I'll vein them and then I'll wire them. And then I'll put them out for you so that then I can use already dry petals to go on with the class. So this is, I call it wingy part. Okay, so I cut here in the middle. So I have this. You can see the growth. Okay, so I cut a bit of the head. I call it the head. It's like the head. This one stands like the arms. This is like a head. And then these are the legs, the two legs. I'm going to cut out two out of it. Okay. Two of it. Okay. And then, let me see if I can get, no, I can get another out of it. Okay, this should do for right now. Okay, then quickly take it back inside a cover, because when you leave your flowers, your paste cut out like this, somehow you tend to have them dry up. So we're going to be working with wire 26. Just pick up. I'll just show you how to cut in case you have not tried your hands on it before. I always use wire 26. It's light and it's wire 26 white, so that whatever I do, you will not see the lines of the white because it's white. That's why I love it so much. So I'll cut this wire into three. One. When you're cutting your wire, it's better that you slant it a little. because you want to thread this wire right into the petal. So sometimes I try to snap it so that there will be an easy push. So now you lift up that wire. This is just water. You can use edible glue, you can use water. I'm going to be making use of water. So just hold it. Holding the petal, I hope the camera sees it very well. Hold the wire and the petal on one hand and then you thread through. Like that. Did you see? The wire will go. Usually in Nigeria, because we have quite a very wet kind of forest region, kind of, the humidity is high. Most of the time, just concentrate on this so that they'll be able to see it. So if I'm wiring most of the time in Nigeria, I do the whole length, because if not, after some time it falls off. But just know that wiring it halfway is okay for any petal normally. But just because of our wet weather, sometimes I have to do it all through so that it can last. So this also, this is the head. I seem like a head. I just went halfway. You can see how far I went. These are the two arms, beautiful arms. And then I thread, threading it, just use your thumb and then index finger to hold it and guide your wire. It will go. You will not see it in the front, you will not see it in the back, because I guided it well. I'll do one more. Is the same thing. Once you cut the part, there are some cutters that will have maybe just like two of the cutters. So there are some that will have like three. There are some that have all the parts, you know, depending on your stockist. So whatever, whoever is your stockist will determine whether you have two or three cutters. I have four parts to this particular flower. So this is the wing. Let me start with that. This is the both wing. So I have just one, so I'll just do one. I've already done some petal screen. You just engage it like that properly. Let it sit comfortably on the veina. The veina is not so pronounced, it's just the natural way. Just small veins down. I don't know if you can see it very well. Just press. It's very important to put pressure. That's what brings it out, because it's just little veining. Naturally, it's not a very aggressive veining. So you have something that looks a bit like this, beautiful in itself. Now, how do I dry it? I can use some of the flower dryers. I also use the apple tray. Some of us, the apple tray, I make use of it. So like this, I just allow it to sit quietly in here. Camera, you can see you see. Drying these flower petals is very, very important. When you dry it, that's when it comes out the way it should. Okay, I left off something. I just do a little bit of softening, just soften. Don't frill. Okay, it looks very put together naturally. When I want to do big petals, I use big bowl too. So just soften the edge a little. Don't go and start feeling it as if you're doing something like peony. So just soften it a little, and then you now put it in a former for it to dry. I dry very well before I use. That place where the wire is, just bend it a little, bend it inside. Okay, and just and then it's good to go, like that. Okay, so this is for this now. Then the very head, in my book I described it as the head petal. That's what I call it. So the head petal, just see this veina is so nice. It forms it the way it should be naturally. This, it was made out of natural petal itself. Just pushing like that. Okay, and then gently, softly. Your petals should be handled with a lot of care, a lot of love. Some people will say the way I handle flowers, that's the way I love to handle them, because I love them. So just soften it a little. It's still retaining that bulb there. Okay. I hope we are following. Then you can put it there to dry. All right. I hope you're with me. Remember, send us questions when you are, when if there's any part of it you don't understand. And this is the right and the left wing of the, see, this is the way it goes. So just put in, and then this is the left. Let's see. Okay. So you can do a right and left, put a little bit of pressure. And then for this part, you just put it in there. And then you just press down. You can see it comes as natural as the petals itself. So just quickly, they are smaller, so I tend to use the smaller bowl too. Supposed to be here, yeah. So just use the smaller one and just soften the edge, soften it. It makes the petals come alive and it makes it to become a little bit more natural. Alright, so I'll put it in here. So this one we bend it a little and then put it in here. So now you have just one more petal. But like I said, I already have one going. That's good. That's great. Okay. So when you've done that, you allow them to dry. You allow them to dry. Now I'm going to do the board for the moth orchid. That's actually where we're supposed to start. But all the same, we go on with it. We're going to do the board. Now, the board for the moth orchid is very, always it's easy to do, even though it's just make a little ball. First of all, roll it in the palm of your finger. I know you'd have washed your hands so it should be clean. And then that your brush, pick up water or pick up edible glue, and then you thread it into the ball like that. Then with your hand, you make something that looks like a corn or a drop. Like a teardrop, yes, teardrop. So this is a bit bigger than what I want. So I just pinch up what I don't want. If you don't want anything, just pick it up. That's the beauty of the gum paste. Very pliable, very forgiving. So the way it is now, you use the smallest part of your bowl tool and then you indent like that. You indent and then you have that hole. Please, I need you to really come close to be able to. Then with your tweezer, you took the beginning of it just like that. And then let it come forward a little. I can go back in and then in then. Can you see? It's very, very important that you get it like that. So when you've done that part, you need to allow this to dry. You kind of curve it forward. It comes forward like that. Then you allow it to dry. Very important. If you don't allow it to dry, when you're tying, it's going to wear right off. Now, to the throat. It's called a throat. To make the throat of an orchid, that's one of the most important parts of an orchid, the throat. With your flower paste, you get your flower paste, okay? And the same thing, you can run it on the table, but because I choose to wire it, I use my glue board to do it. So the same sausage, and then you quickly roll out. I'm going to be cutting just one petal, so I'm really okay, content with just making a small one. This is where you want it to be, and then you spread forward. Usually I'll say forward ever, just forward, so that because when you go back, you remove the groove that you're trying to build up. this should be thin, but don't make it too thin. Because sometimes when it's too thin, the tendency to break is there. So I'm going to take this out of the way. Camera, you can see the glue. So what you do is just to cut. I don't need the whole length, so just cut where I need it the most. Remove the excess paste. Like I say, always put it in a bag so that it can remain fresh. Now I'll put it on a pan so that you see where we're going. This is one of the most important parts of our flour. So where do I start right now? I'll simply thread in a wire. I just pinch out a little because I don't want it to be so lengthy. Then that's the wire. Remember our threading. With your thumb and your index finger, you just pass through gently. For this one, I like it to fold. I like to get to the end of it completely. You know why? So that when I bend it, I can get it exactly how I want it. So the way it is now, I've already threaded it. So what I'll do next now is to, I'm going to take in this delicate part, very delicate. I'm going to take it in and soften the edges of these ones first of all. So what I'll do, I'll use the smallest one and then take it in. Like I said, this is one of the most important aspects of the orchid, the moth orchid, or phalaenopsis as some people will call it. And then soften the edges, and then soften the part of this. Then just before I bend it to its proper shape, I just make a little bit of a ball to a ball. And then make it look a little bit like that, very small. And then I put a little water in the middle, like this. And then engage that small, tiny dot. Very small. Then you use your modeling tool and make, just divide it into two. Anytime you see the center of the flower, you see this very small tiny thing in the middle of it, use your modeling tool to adjust it to that stage. That makes me wonder. I don't know if you can see it. Okay. And see, I think we can actually see it more on this. So right now what I do now, I'll now make use of the wire I used all through, and I bend, just bend, bend, bend. This is very delicate. Most of the time when I need 10, I do 20, because sometimes, because of all the soft wings, sometimes when you start working on the flower, it starts breaking, so make extra. So once I get all these ones to comply, to puff into each other. Sometimes I use this to dry it, but sometimes when you dry it, it has a tendency to move more. So I leave it bent like that and I dry it on the form like this. This is how I dry the throat of my moth orchid. You can see there are ones there already that are dry. These are the ones I'm going to dust for us to continue the pass. Are we okay at the moment? Are we getting it? Are we flowing? I hope we are, because I'll be glad for you to be able to flow, for you to be able to understand what we are saying now, how far we have gone. Remember, ask me a question anytime. So this is already a finished one and it's dry. I did it this morning. I just give it an hour and it's good to go. So as soon as you're done with this part of it, the next part will be to dust. Dusting. So what I do, I start off with dusting the throat. That's where I start. And I enjoy it because that's when the flower comes to life. You know? That's when it becomes more natural. I'm going to be making use of lemon or golden yellow dust. edible dust called the yellow or which other yellow? Yes, any one of them. So I like to make the needle. It does not mean it has to be just this anytime, but this is what I use for mine. So I've already put in the dust. So what I will do next is to pick it up. I start dusting from the throat. The throat first. Okay. This or this. Let me see the one I like most. So okay. Two of them are just cute, very nice. So let me make it your best right now. So for that throat, please let the camera again. That center of the throat, you just dust that needle. Be careful, all those things are breakable, like, I mean, breakable. So when I have that done that way, I don't know if I can take it out from the camera to see like this. I want to paint. Yes. So I want to paint. Yes, I have the alcohol with me. I mean edible spirit. That's what I'm going to make this of. Let me take this to the side so that it doesn't knock away. So I have this dust color, it's a black magic. You either use it or use the brown, light brown, but black magic works for me anytime, so I make use of it a lot. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the edible glue inside the dust like that. Small, just a little. Then I have a very fine brush, like a 1.1 or 0.1 millimeter, very, very important. Okay, so now this is where the work is. Okay, you're going to make this star-like thing. So you mark right from that small ball that we divided into two. You take it out like that. Don't be in a hurry. This is very important. Don't be in a hurry. Let it be as thin as possible. Can you see? Can the camera see? Can you get it? Okay, good. So, just don't be in a hurry. Anytime you look into an orchid, this starlight thing looks so pretty and so natural. Then I just take a little bit of a dot, just dot the top like that, small, and that will complete the throat of the orchid. The throat of the orchid is complete. Okay, can you get it there? Very, very important. So now I'm going to be, we're making a very good time. I'm going to try to dust. I'm going to do this in white, okay? I'm going to tie this flower in white, but let me show you how to dust one of the petals of the orchid, in case you ever want to do a colored one, because I have a colored one there, and then I have a white one. I'm going to be tying together a white one, but let me just give you an idea of how to dust, because it's very, very important. Now, I dusted this with pink, hot pink, I call it hot pink or very light pink, because I want to make it lighter, even though this is quite a bit deep, but what I did was to make it lighter. I don't want it to be too deep. I also made use of black magic. You either use black magic or use aubergine. Aubergine and black magic are basically same, like dark, what are that dust is close to it, like a dark wine color. That's aubergine or black magic, any one of them can really work out for you. So what I did is to do, let me see the brushes.
So I'm going to make up use of the brush. It becomes a problem on how to handle it. So once you have put in the little, then you use your brush. What makes it come out natural is when you use your dry brush, the brush that doesn't have so much to it, and then you go over and over and over. If it's possible, you follow the lines of the veining. Okay, you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so once I'm done with that, I'll use the black magic or bajin, like I said, and then I just go through it. It's small too, don't put too much. And then I just take it some, you can decide to take some lights. And then whatever you have on, spread it. But you can see that I'm going one stroke. I'm not just pabbling. I'm just going a stroke, like a stroke. You really have to spread it. If not, it will look as if it's not natural. For you to make it natural, Moth Orchid has so many different varieties and colors. You can see what we have here, but varieties, okay? Okay, so as much as possible, you go along. So let me quickly dust this one. I'm already getting excited at the dust because the white is just there. So I'll just do it quickly. Okay. So even if I'm not talking, you're looking at my hands. If I want to dust this, what I usually do, I just do one color, finish one color, okay? Make time, and then don't be too much in a hurry. I'm just hurrying because I've been doing this almost all the time, so don't be too much in a hurry so that you'll be able to get it yourself. Work will work. Okay, all right, I'm running so that I don't want too much color in there. So I just put as little as I can. These are the two wings. This is the head and then the arms. So quickly, I run through again with black magic. Okay. I took too much. Remember, there's no flower that is exactly the same. That's how God made it natural. Awesome God. There's a way He made. You know, when you see things in the natural, don't wait for all your petals to be on point exactly. In fact, when you have a little bit of dirt somewhere, it's just as natural as it comes. No two petals, no two flowers are the same basically. So what you need to do is just to... Alright. Okay, so what I'm doing is just to log in a little bit of black magic. Follow the veinings of the flower. You see, when I pick it up, I drop it. When I see some flowers, I'm like, oh wow, that's one too much color in there. Okay, so, and particularly the edge, I like to have the darker shades at the edge of the petals. The darker shades at the edge comes in there. Alright, so now I have my five petals. Is anybody excited at seeing the end of it? I am, if you are not. So what I do right now is I use a wire 18. I think I have one. I want to couple it together. I want it to be strong. So sometimes wire 22 is more like it. I just use wire 22 to couple it together. Then when I want to tie it, sometimes if I need it to be stronger, I just use wire 18. But for this time, this is going to work. I'm excited. At the end, how's it gonna be? How's it gonna be? Oh, it's gonna be nice. I tell you the truth. So, what do you do? You start off. Oh, yes, I left off one very important guy. That's his throat. So, what I do for the board for the throat, what I do, I just use the same yellow and to dust it. Just majorly the back of it, because it's the back that you see most of the time bending over, watching over like an angel of the Lord. Awesome. So with this,
what you do to couple it together. I can move this by the side. Thank you. And just take it out of the way. Take this out of the way. Okay. The camera, I hope it sees exactly the table. Okay, and then, so what I do, be careful. These things are very, very delicate. So I'll just bend the wire backwards because the orchid has a way of facing the people or the camera. And then you take the throat and then you engage it like that. Engage it like this. Then you put in that wire 22 just to straighten the petals. And then the tape, I use brown because naturally the orchid does not always come in just pure green, okay? Depending on the species anyway. So I just use that, I can dust it later. So I just cut into it. You know, it's better to use a half-width tape. This is how to get a half-width tape. Some people can buy, they sell, you can get some places. If you can't, just slide it into two, a half-width tape. Using a half-width tape will make the flower to be a bit stronger. Okay, when you tie it, to make the flower to be stronger than to use a full width. And because it's so tiny, it's better to use a half-way tape. So this is what is going to come on it. Remember what I said, you engage the little board on the throat of the bucket, watching over it like that, as if it's an angel. Then you add wire 22, and then you tape. You tape. You tape, okay, and then you tape. Normally, I just tape all the way down first. Even though I'm going to add other petals, tape all the way down first to make sure that it's firm and it's the way you want it. Can you see that? Guys, can you see that? All right, it's coming together little by little. It's coming together. Okay, so after this is done, the next thing I do, be careful. Once you touch these people, they are broken. So you have to be very careful how you do it. So the very first petal I put is the head petal, the one I was calling like a head petal. You just engage it at the base like that. Okay, it's the head petal. The camera can see this very well. Very, very important. So, and then you turn, you twist, you turn. Okay, so when you see the head petal is properly engaged, then you put the two arms. Always fun. When you put the two arms, you engage it in such a way that it comes in. You see it? I hope you can see. Okay. All right. So what I do, I just roll it down, round and round. Okay. When I'm done with that, I will put in the next petal. Like that. And then you turn round and round and round. You can see it coming together little by little. Then the base ones, you just engage this. In the book, in the Exotic Sugar Flower book written by Chineze, it's completely, I did a full fuchsia pink moth orchid. Beautiful, I love it. I love the colors. I love the white because, I mean, it's so popular. But sometimes when these fiery colors come in, it's something else. Okay, so I'm turning, you know, with the half-width tape, turning and turning.
it's very important that it stays. You don't want to do a flower that will be dangling. So when you tip it, when you have tipped it like that, then you just go. Excuse me, I'm around, let me just put it on my face so I can put it properly before I give you the final thing. Very careful. These guys, I told you, very delicate, they can break. So at this point in time, Tara, we got our moth orchid. Small, portable burst. And then I have. Let me just look at it. Sorry, camera. Yeah. So this is the colored one. This is the plain white orchid. This is the one. This is the one I just did. You can actually do this in a variety of ways. So quickly make an orchid ball, just make a ball. And then make like a teardrop, like I said, a little teardrop, it will help you. Then with a shell blade modeling tool, your eye, divide into three parts. A shell blade modeling tool, you can see this is what it means to divide into three parts. I hope the camera is able to see. So with your wire 26 or 24, you just hold and then bring it down. I try to make it to be rounded and not a teardrop kind of at this stage. So you just use your shell blade to make the divisions to be clear. Okay, you can have different sizes. You know, when the body is coming, you can have different sizes to it. So as soon as you're done like that, you just use green. I have kiwi, small green. You just have a very light green shade and then put it down. Very light green shade. Then take that green and then run through. You know, I just did this, but because of the way it is, I can actually walk around it. You just put a little bit of green. Don't make it too deep, but it's supposed to be light. Most of the time, for you to actually get a very nice depth of colors, it's good to go through colors twice. Okay, then with my brush for black magic. The brush for black magic is like this. Okay, so quickly use the same black magic we used and then go through the centers of it. Just small. Remember what I said? Take your dust, just go through it, go over it. Just play it over there. Not too deep, not too light. And then go over it. Small. Now I have so much, my green is disappearing, so I just put in a little bit of green. I like to have a little bit of green. I like to work with soft brushes. I think I want to still like to be green, just to the green. I like to have the green, very light green. Okay. All right. Good. So that will make for the board. Okay, for the board of the orchid. I had this one before, so let me just, it's already done and dried and dusted, like they will say. So I just get a little bit of the black magic in there.
Okay. So, what I do to put it together, I just use wire 18. This is the last part, and then we're good to go. We already have all the ones that are done. So, I use that same half width. Using a half width tape makes a lot of difference. So I'm going to cut into it. And then, like that, like that. Okay, just a little. So what I do to this right now is that I just dip it. I'm almost done, practically done, guys. If you're looking out there, I'm practically done. So with this, when I do that, I am almost done. Okay, I'm so glad that we are able to stay through. I'm telling you, it's not easy to stay through such a long class. So I'll start with the light, the smaller one. And then I tape them together. Add a tape. I'm practically done, like I said. Okay, right now, just tape it together. Tape it together. And then add the flower we have done. Halfway through, just allowing the flower to be out. Okay, like that. You know, some of it is still very soft. Put it together and then I take it together. Now this is just one orchid and then four. And with this we come to the end of this beautiful class. It's not easy, but we're there. I'm excited that we have come to the end. Oh yeah, I'm excited. Really, I love this flower and I'm just hoping that you're able to do it at your convenience. Even if you can't do it right now, you can always go to Isis page, you can always get this flower and then you can do it. Right now, we have come to the class and I want to appreciate the International Giving Exploration Society. I've always been with you. I've attended Isis like 12 times in a row in the US. I've gone to so many cities, but this is the first of its kind virtual. Awesome. And I'm glad that you made it possible for me to be a part of this. Thank you, Isis. May the Lord God Almighty bless you. And for my viewers, it takes a lot to sit this long. You must be passionate about flowers, if not, some people get bored. Thank you for being with me. Thank you for hanging out with me. May the Lord bless you. I pray that you will try your hands on this. And if you do, please send me a private DM me or send me your pictures of honeysuckle cakes. At honeysuckle cake, Instagram, Facebook, all my social handles, at honeysuckle cakes. Please don't forget, if you send me a private message, I'm going to be glad. And I'm glad that you made it. I love you all.